Hey, what's up, my ninjas? Shinobi here with another Diablo 3 video for you guys. The other day, I woke up and a lot of people were spamming me and saying, "Shinobi, did you see what's going on with Diablo fans? There's this data mining thing going on, and there's this all this leaked information about the expansion, and someone got their hands on this, and they're still up in the air on whether it's like an inside thing, like someone from Blizzard somehow got this information leaked, or we don't know what's going on with it." However, a lot of people want to get my 2 cents about it. What's going on, what I think about all this, because, I mean, as you can see on the page, there is a crazy amount of information that has been put out about the expansion. Somebody has been staying up nonstop and uploading all this information about all the, abilities that have changed on certain classes and just everything, that all these things that have changed like crazy. And first off, for me, as a YouTuber, someone, one of the only YouTubers that has literally been playing Diablo 3 nonstop all the way up until now, and constantly putting out videos for Diablo, you would think that myself, I would be more hyped about this than pretty much almost anybody out there, right? I mean, I've made, this is what I do, right? However, I want you guys to think about a couple of things in the course of this video, and I'm gonna give you a little bit of demonstrations, and I'm also gonna maybe try and shed some light on this stuff. Now, I mean, today when I looked at it, and I wasn't going to make a video about this to begin with in the first place, because I think that you shouldn't freak out too much just yet, because a lot of things can change, and I'll explain why a lot of things can change, even though there are so many changes that are on here that it's crazy. I mean, pretty much the entire game as we know it in Diablo, except for the way the gameplay mechanics work, is pretty much going to be changing just from going through this. I haven't even read through everything. One thing that I noticed right off the bat, though, when the class changes, was Battle Rage. And you know how the Whirlwind spec needs Battle Rage and Into the Fray in order to keep gaining that fury to be able to actually do the Whirlwind spec. Well, according to this, according to what's going on here, is you gain, instead of before, like you gain fury, 15 additional fury, what Into the Fray is going to do now is gain 1% critical strike chance for each enemy within 10 yards while under the effect of Battle Rage. Pretty much meaning that Whirlwind barbs are dead. Plain and simple, they're eliminating Whirlwind barbs. Maybe they'll bring them back in some other way. I haven't read what every ability does. Maybe they change that to a different ability, or maybe it's built into Whirlwind. I don't know. I haven't read through all this stuff, and the reason that I haven't read through all this stuff is because I don't want to freak out about every little change that may or may not happen. Now, the reason I'm telling you all this stuff, guys, is because in the video footage behind me, you're seeing some Diablo 3 video footage here. Now, this is not the expansion, so don't freak out. This is from back in 2008, I believe, the first known video footage we had of Diablo 3. And as you can tell from the video, it is completely different. I mean, well, not completely. I mean, it's still the same kind of mechanics gameplay-wise, but the UI looks different. I mean, if you go watch the entire video, and you can find it on YouTube somewhere. I got it a long time ago, and I know it's still on YouTube. You can find it. But this was 3 years before Diablo 3 even came out, and they were talking about features that were going to be put into the game. They were excited. They're like, "Check out this feature where you can, when you equipped a weapon that has this on it, you can slow and you can do this and you can do like things that aren't even in the game." You just have to go see the video for yourself, but you can see just from the gameplay that some things are different, the UI looks different, and all that kind of stuff. And the reason that I'm even bringing this up is because these things change a lot. And even though, yes, there's a lot of information on here, and that's great, but does that mean that that's what it's going to be like when it comes out? No. A lot of you already know that, so there's not really a point to even say that. However, do you know why that is, though? That is the case. Now, I'm a big movie buff, a big game buff, have been my entire life. And when I follow movies, I don't follow the actors. I follow the directors, because I want to see what the directors are doing behind the scenes that are going to shape the way the movie's going to be. The actors are just the pawns in the director's greater goal, right? Greater achievement that they want to try and go after. So, what happens when a movie is being filmed? Well, there are so much footage. There's so much footage that isn't used, that gets cut. You guys know the director's cut, but there's way more than that. Myself, in particular, when I film a video, when I'm doing a guide for Diablo, I usually have about, an hour or two worth of footage of me farming and doing this and that, and then I break it down and cut it to a 3 to 4 minute or 5 minute long video. And the reason you do that is because more is always better. And I feel like developers in gaming companies do the same thing. It only makes sense, right? You want to make sure that you cover everything and make sure that you have a bunch of stuff that you can actually go with. So what they do is they come up with all these changes and they put a whole bunch into the game right in the beginning, and then they cut things and go, okay, that wasn't balanced, we'll cut that out. Okay, that doesn't really, that doesn't put the game in the direction that we want it to go. We're gonna cut that out. We're gonna do this and we're gonna cut that out. And the reason why I'm even telling you any of this is because I feel like the Diablo 3 community is so strong about voicing their opinion towards Blizzard when Blizzard makes the smallest mistake or they don't implement something that they thought they were going to. And I don't want people to get too hyped up in the game and go, "Oh my God, well, I mean, when I looked at Diablo fans, you said that that Whirlwind Barbs are pretty much going to be gone because Into the Fray is to change now." So, and then what's this? You bring Whirlwind back or something, like, some people that maybe didn't want to do the Whirlwind thing anymore and wanted to change it up. That's just an example, but that's where I'm going with this, is that you shouldn't freak out too much about this stuff. I mean, you can go and read all this stuff and I'll link it for you. Just go to Diablo fans. They're updating information all the time. From what I know so far, Blizzard hasn't really come out to speak about this or anything. I mean, just the fact that this information got leaked to begin with, I mean, it's definitely an NDA, like a non-disclosure agreement. There's no way this information should have been put out. So Blizzard may do something about this and get it taken away or something, or I don't know. But I mean, that's a reason why it's not in beta right now, and it's because the game is not ready for beta. Now, you have multiple stages behind developing a game. You have the part in the beginning of the development stage where they're coming up with ideas, conceptual ideas. They're getting concepts for the game, and they're thinking of, okay, we're going to go with this, we're going to go with that. Now, everybody goes over their notes and they go, okay, this and that, what do you think we should, go with for this? And they write down all these ideas and they have, pages and pages and paragraphs and paragraphs and paragraphs full of great ideas that could possibly make it into the game. Well, 50 to 80% of them usually won't because they don't work out the way that they wanted to, or if they tested it. And with PvP, that should probably be coming out in this in this expansion. Every little class change that they do is going to reflect that. They need to make sure that they can't make things overpowered. They need to make sure a lot of things. And then when they get to that stage and they go, okay, now we're going to test this, and we're going to do development testing. So the developers test it. That's pretty much what's going on right now, is developer testing, and somehow somebody got a hold of this. And then after that, they get it ready in a more polished game to go to closed beta. And then with closed beta, they get a little bit more polished, go to open beta, and then go to release finally. So there's a lot of stages behind all of this. And right now, with all of this information that's out there right now, the main thing I want you to take from this video is just try not to get too freaked out about this and see, oh my God, I saw this and I can't wait for that to be in the game and I'm gonna buy the game just because that's gonna be in the game. Don't do that right now. Try not to freak out, because if you do that and then it's not in the game when the game comes out, you're gonna regret buying the game. And that's what I think a lot of people were upset with Diablo 3 when it first came out, because a PvP thing wasn't implemented, which that is a huge thing for the game, so I completely understand. I mean, I myself was feeling the exact same way. However, when it comes to all these little changes and this and that, and there's some pretty big changes in here as well too, try not to think too much into these and think that it's this huge change and that's what it's going to be when it comes out. Wait until later on, so you see some official things, maybe some closed beta. Even in closed beta, things change a lot. In open beta, things still change a lot. So you won't actually know for 100% until the game is actually released what it's going to be. You can get hyped up about this and you can get excited for it, because I'm excited for a lot of these changes that I see in here, but I'm not going to freak out if I don't get those changes. I know just because of the amount of work that Diablo is putting into this, I mean, we can actually, if we take some good out of this, the amount of work that Diablo is putting into this, just from all the changes that are here, we know that the game is going to be a lot better than we were hoping for. So, I mean, good news is the game's probably going to be really fun, and there's going to be a lot of awesome changes that you guys are going to like. However, try not to get too crazy and be a little more skeptical on this information, and, you know, just give it some time and see where things go, and then finally you'll see, you know, exactly what the end result is going to be. So I'm going to update you guys on more information as time comes out, as more official information comes out straight from Blizzard, straight from the main sources, and when things are guaranteed and set in stone, this will be released, this will be coming out like this, then you can get excited for it. But until then, just try and keep an open mind about this stuff. Anyways, my name is Shinobi, and until next time, thanks for watching. Melee attacks when they are close to you, and vitality and dexterity as much as you can. Also comes with the three sockets. Now the gloves, like I said, craft those, but for the time being, I got these ones: dexterity, vitality, armor, crit chance, and get as much crit chance as you can, and also I got crit damage on there.